AT level 4 and 5 computing assignment. Okay, you have to write your learner name, write what is your name and then your ID registration on it. Okay, now we are giving you some scenario. You have recently been appointed as an IT advisor to a small business consortium in your local area. The members are typically sole traders who meet regularly to discuss common issues directly impacting on their businesses and other matter affecting society in general. One of the emerging topics is IT to help manage and develop their business, but also the wider issue of how IT impacts on society. At the next meeting, you have been asked to present information to them relating to IT issues in society. This will enable them to understand the requirement and ensure they can adopt best practice in their own businesses. So now, what is your activity one? Have you understood the scenario? They are saying that you have been appointed as IT advisor to a small consortium or in local area, right? Consortium is what? Consortium is a building, right? It's like a partnership firm, right?
Yes,
Right.
ma'am.
Have the members are typically sole traders who meet regularly to discuss common issues directly impacting on their businesses, right? What happens that the member, whoever is the member of that partnership firm, they came regularly and discussed the common issues that are directly impacting on their businesses. And what are these issues? These issues are related to IT, right? And other matters affecting society in general. What of the emerging topic is IT to help manage and develop their businesses, but also the wider issue of how IT impacts on society, right? All over whatever we have done discussions, what was those discussions? Those discussions was that how IT is impacting your the society, right? So now what we have to do, next, they are saying at the next meeting, you have been asked to present information to them relating to IT issues in society. This will enable them to understand the requirement and ensure they can adopt best practice in their own businesses. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
What
Yes,
is
ma'am.
happening that you have to make your, you can say, make a you can say you have to gather information about whatever the issues are there regarding to the development or regarding to IT, right? What IT have you can say produce issues in society. So what is your activity one? The business consortium has asked you to inform the members how IT has changed the way people live and work. You will need to use actual example to illustrate the point, right? Like for example, in your first lecture with me, I have taught you that what changes over the time have IT brought from you can say from here on this world, right? Okay, and I also have told you that from where it all started. It all started from when Industrial Revolution have begun, right?
Yes,
So
ma'am.
now they are saying that you will need to use actual example to illustrate the point you are making and help their understanding. You need to produce the presentation materials and an accompanying guide which relate to the last 50 years and provide an analysis of the most significant development in IT over the time, an evaluation of how IT has changed society in the time period, and an explanation of how IT has changed the way people work in this time, right? What is the first thing that is required from the you have to analyze that what are the most significant development in IT in over time, right? For example, what are the significant development? What is it's like in last 50 years, mankind, or you can say in last 100 years, mankind have known that how to fly. Men have known that how they can, you can say, reach moon. Men know that how they can communicate on long distance, over long distance, and they also know that how they should send information over the long distance, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And then what you have to evaluate, that how IT has changed the society in this time period. You will tell me that, or you will tell me that what are the impacts, or sorry, what are the, you can say, changes that society have over the time because of IT, right? Yeah. What is, you can say, what is the, you can say, benefits and you can say losses that people are facing because IT have changed society, right? Then you have to explain how IT has changed the way people work. First, you will tell that how IT have changed society, and then you have to tell that how IT has changed the way people work, right? And in addition, you should provide an explanation of the impact on individual of living in the information age. Okay, you will tell that whatever is the, you can say, impact that has been brought over the living in this information age, right? You can say, you can see your...
I have a doubt.
What?
In the first one, obviously the first three points, the analysis, the evaluation, the explanation, there's nothing negative that we can point out. But when it says, in addition, you should provide an explanation of the impact on individuals, here will we write about the negative impact as well? Because when we're giving analysis and we're giving evaluation over the change in 50 years, obviously we're writing about all the developments. But the third, after the third point, when it says that we need to give an explanation of the impact, do we also give an explanation of the negative impacts?
And yes, ma'am, I would like to add that in activity two, it's saying that the, you know, whoever we are giving the presentation to, he's impressed. So is it necessary to discuss the negative points?
Okay, here we have, what you have to do that you don't have to just tell, you can say negative points, you have to make them a mix, right? You have to, you can say, make a comparison. Okay? When you will make a comparison, obviously in activity two, if it is saying that the person is impressed by you, so why he is impressed by you? He is impressed by you because you are explaining each and every point to him, them, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So when I have gave you lecture, have I gave you only negative points?
No, ma'am. No. No, ma'am. My question was that obviously we'll be stating all the positive points. When we are giving the analysis of the most significant development and we'll be evaluating the IT has changed society over the period of time, because obviously we have to show that how it has improved. But when it says in addition, you should provide an explanation of the impact, here I was saying that with the positive, we'll also be mentioning the negatives, right?
Right,
because we're presenting it to the business.
You have to make a comparison, right?
Okay.
You have to provide positive as well as you have to provide negative. If you are going to say that internet have helped us, for example, if you are making a point that internet had helped us to provide information, okay, can we wait 2 minutes because there is azan at my, you can say, in my locality, right? So azan is calling, please wait for 2 minutes. Okay. So what I was saying, I'm saying that you have to make a comparison. What you have to do, you have to make a comparison. For example, if I am saying that, okay, yes, if I say that internet have made our lives very easy, right? Internet have made, you can say, internet have made our lives very easy. We can send information to long distances in just few seconds. Okay. So you, what will you do? You will just make, you can say, you will make some points, and what will you do then? Also, you will indicate that what were the negative impacts on that? You can say what internet have done, right? You will put a heading that what are the positive impacts? You can put a heading that what are the negative impacts, right, class?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the activity two? Okay, so far so good. Activity one is explained.
Yes, ma'am, but there's one more question which may sound very stupid, but I'd still ask. It says here that you need to produce the presentation materials, but obviously here we won't be presenting any presentation materials. It will be in a form of an article.
I will confirm this to you, okay?
Okay,
that whether you have to make it on PPT or whether you have to make it. Okay, class, read out activity two.
Okay, class, have you been through activity two?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what is activity two? The manager of the business consortium is was impressed with your presentation and has asked you to produce a news article which can be displayed on their website. This will inform new business owners about IT issues in society. Okay. Class, what you have to do, that activity one, you have to, in activity one, you have to make a presentation, right? And in activity two, what you have to do, you have to present, you have to produce an article, right? In a word form, okay? Hello?
Okay, ma'am.
Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
All of you understood whatever I was saying?
Yes.
In first
yes,
one,
ma'am.
You what you will what will you make? You will make a hello, answer me.
A presentation, a PPT in the activity one.
Very good. And what will you make in second one?
Article.
Very good.
Okay, ma'am.
So is there being anything which is more misunderstood? Tell me, I can explain you. Okay, let's read, you can say next thing. The manager of the business consortium was also okay. Okay, this will inform new business owners about IT issue in society. Your article should cover the following points and it should include examples from wider reading and research to support your explanation and evaluation. What is that? That is an explanation of how significant digital citizenship is to the society, an evaluation of current issues in the society relating to personal data. Okay, what is the issue one? Okay, the one number one is not issue. Number one is, you can say it is some kind of know-how that you have to give to your in that article, and then you also have to elaborate it, right? How you will elaborate? You will elaborate it by, you can say, giving a long range of examples, right? So what is long for which topic you have to give examples? You have to give examples for digital citizenship, right? Hello, understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Can anyone tell me what was digital citizenship?
Ma'am, actually, your audio is distorted.
I was saying, what can you tell me that what was digital citizenship?
Like connecting with the internet, like over internet, digitally connecting with others.
Right.
When a person uses the internet or the technology,
yes,
to connect with everyone around them, that's the digital citizenship.
And that doesn't, you can say, necessarily that whatever, you can say, whatever the resource you use for that, right? If you are using your mobile for being connected to a world, or if you are using your laptop, you are using your PC, or maybe you are using your smart you can say TV. You can, through smart TV, you can access internet, right? Or there is,
I was known
that in Pakistan, the company Dollars have introduced a refrigerator. Through what happens that through YouTube is connected, right? On refrigerator. So also that refrigerator is also playing a part for connecting, you can say, in digital citizenship. What was the next thing? Next thing was that you have to evaluate what are the current issue in society relating to personal data, right? So what could be the first issue?
Identity theft.
Yes.
Privacy theft.
Scams,
very good.
Phishing and farming.
Sorry, what are you saying?
Phishing and farming.
What's that?
Ma'am, like taking the bank details. The hackers, they usually give their own made website of their bank, of the customer's bank, in order to get the personal details. Phishing.
Okay. So what is next? So far so good. Activity two is explained to you, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
So
ma'am.
Anything you want to question about it, kindly ask.
No, ma'am.
Everyone is clear?
Yes,
ma'am.
Are you sure? Okay, now I am moving toward activity three. Okay, what is activity three? Okay, this looks very interesting to me. I don't know why. The manager of business consortium would know like a report to help him understand the legal, ethical, and regularity issue in IT. Okay, we have also dealt with this issue, right?
Yes, ma'am. We did this, and even we had a homework on this on the task.
Exactly. So what you have to do, you have to make a report to help him understand. Okay, this would be a report. You can say this will contain a report, right? So this will have a report format. And what is that report format is, I will tell you, inshallah. Okay, so they are saying that you have to write a report and you have to tell that what you have to make a report in such a way that he should understand what are the legal, ethical, and regularity issue in IT, right? For example, if you are going to launch an app, what would be the legal issues you will face, what will be the, what will be the ethical issue that you are going to face, and what will be the regularity issue that you are going to face with IT, okay? Okay, he will then be able to use this information in meetings with any new business leaders who are considering joining the consortium. Your report should cover the what he is saying. That he's saying that what will he you can say do, he will do that whatever the report you have given him, he will you can say represent that report in front of other young you can say entrepreneurs, and he will persuade them to join the consortium, right? And you know what, when your club is being, you can say, bigger, what happens that, for example, if your consortium is being like, other people will say that, wow, it is a big consortium, it is a valuable consortium, right? And maybe after some years, okay, what happens? So where were we, students? We were like, we were discussing that what were the legal, ethical, and regularity issues. Okay, I have sent you that slide in which I have explained all over the legal issues, the ethical issues, the regularity issues, right? You know that legal issue was patent, copyright, right? Remember
yes,
that?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
ethical issues were privacy and piracy, right? That was that bullet, right? So what you have to do, you have to make a report on them. Okay, what will you do in presentation? Okay, what is the format usually in presentation? What we do, we use bullets, right? And we just show the, you can say the audience, the presentation. And what we do that we add bullets in that presentation. And when we come to that bullets, we explain them, right? Like I do, what happens that there are bullets written on the screen, but I give you additional information, right? So this is yes, how ma'am. We make presentations. But when we go toward the articles or when we go towards the reports, right? What happens that in reports, we give each and every information that we know about the, you can say, know about the, you can say whatever the point is. For example, if you are going to tell about the piracy, what will you do that? What is actually piracy aid? What is actually is going to happen if someone have, you can say, doing piracy? What happens to the, you can say, the original owner of the product, right? How the original owner of the product get, you can say, in loss because of piracy, right? For example, have you purchased the window, you can say, the window you are using in on your laptop?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Every one of you?
In one of the laptops is purchased, and the other it's copied from somewhere.
Okay, why it is copied from somewhere? Because in actually, that is the pirated copy, right? Okay, obviously, but it's
yes,
the pirated copy, that pirated copy also has some restriction, right? For example, when yes. I was in my previous laptop, that was a pirated copy of Windows that I was using. What happens because of that? I was restricted to something, right? I can't access each and every, you can say, the benefit that Microsoft Windows gives to its user. I was not able to access that. But now in this laptop, I have original copy of that. So what happens that, Microsoft Windows update the programs, whatever they see that they need updation for, and they update that program automatically, right? For example, they give a pop-up message once, and when you have said that yes, you allowed them to update that program, they will update that program automatically, right? So one of that is good, but sometimes what happens that when you need that program, eventually what happens, they just start updating your window. That happens in our today class. Our today class was delayed because my Microsoft window just start updating my Zoom out of nowhere. So my Zoom was, you could say, stopped working. So here was what I was saying. Okay, then what you have to do, we were discussing your report should cover the following points. What is the first point? First point is an evaluation of the current legal, ethical, and regularity issue in IT, right? What will you say? You will say about what are the current situations that we found impossible in legislature? What are the problems that we face in ethical background? And what are the problems that we face when we are going to regulate some, you can say, technology or regulate some new tech, right? For example, if you have made a robot and you are going to say that I made a robot to help army in defeating, you can say, enemies. So they will, first they will test that robot, that whether that robot is going to kill enemies or whether that robot is going to kill our army people as well, right? And when they will, make sure about each and everything about the tech, then they will allow you to regulate it, then they will allow you to sell it commercially, then they will allow you to make copies of it, right? So that's are the, you can say, you have to evaluate these points. Then there is an assessment of the importance of ethical guidelines in IT. Okay, you are going to give some of the ethical guidelines in IT, right? I have told you what are the ethical guidelines of IT. You don't have to invade anyone's privacy, and you don't have to invade, you can say, everyone's personal data. Okay, what are the impacts, for example, if you refuse to follow the ethical guidelines, and what are the impacts if you, for example, follow those ethical guidelines, right? Then you have, in addition, in order to help him understand the information in a stated context, he has specifically asked you to include a session in the report which evaluates the impact of current legal, ethical, or regularity issue in IT on specific and identified organization. Right, what are you going to do? You have to evaluate the impact of one current legal, ethical, or regularity issue in IT on a specific and identified organization. Just take an organization. Okay, you can take that organization locally that only works in Saudi Arabia, or you can also take that organization on, you can say, on international basis. Why I am saying this? I am saying this because that will give you, you can say, a vast ground to, you can say, assess on. So choose any one of the organization that is your favorite, and then tell that what was new tech that they were going to regulate. What were the, you can say, regularity issue that they faced? What was the ethical issue for that specific technology they have faced? And what was the legal issue for that technology they have faced, right? Hello?
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, I have a question. Like the last one bullet point, evaluate the impact on any one identified organization. This was our task as well, and I tried doing this one, but it was very difficult to find an organization that is identified, that is having impact in all three terms, ethical, legal, and regulatory. So could you please help giving any examples? Like, okay, then we can, you know, narrow our research and find some.
Okay, okay. Let me tell you one thing, what I have said, okay? Listen carefully. I am saying that you have to take any organization who have recently regulated some tech to their system, right? And then you have to say that is what they have faced, the problems, the ethical problems, or the regularity problems according to that tech, right? For example, let me think, give me a minute, okay? Do you know about Elon Musk?
No, ma'am.
Yes,
Elon
yes,
Musk
ma'am.
Is the, you can say, exactly, he's the founder of Tesla, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So, every one of you know about Tesla, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
So, but when he was going to, you can say, when he was going to introduce that tech, the tech was named as Tesla. What was the issue that he faced, right? For example, when he was going to approve that in his country, the legal issues that he faced, the ethical issues that he faced for that specific tech, and for example, what were the regularity issues? Do you think that it would be easy for him to, you can say, to just introduce a car with having artificial intelligence and no driver on it, and that car will drive itself toward your destiny? Do you think it was easy for him? Obviously, many questions would have been arrived at. What happens if your car is going to, you can say, make a dead end, and what will happen? What happens that these all issues are, you can say, handled by whoever the legal, you can say, guardian of that company is, whoever the ethical guardian of that country, then whoever the regulatory authorities over that country, right? So what he have done, he must have, you can say, approved that Tesla, first of all, to the legal, you can say, legal, you can say, authorities, and then they will say that what the legal issues he have faced. And then you will tell, for example, that what were the ethical issues. Obviously, if you are not using driver and whatever the car is working on, the artificial intelligence, you know, it is not easy for everyone to believe that, for example, this car is going to, you know, work on artificial intelligence. I'm not saying that that artificial intelligence is something bad, but for example, if humans can make mistakes and they have brain and they have, you know, critical thinking, obviously what will happen if something that is you can say, I'm not saying that artificial intelligence is bad, but you know what happens, that there are some of the possibilities when you are on road. There are some possibilities. Maybe whoever is making the algorithm of that AI, they have missed some possibility. And what happens that when the Tesla is meeting that possibility, maybe that caused accident, right? So then you have some regularity issue that are, you can say the local traffic police is going to allow that type of car on, you can say, on roads. Are people are going to allow those type of cars on roads? Are showrooms are going to sell those cars? Or for example, if you are, for example, Tesla is not made in Saudi Arabia or Tesla is not made in Pakistan. So if Pakistani or Saudis want that, they have to import that. So are the regularity authorities are going to, you can say, allow them to have that car in their company, in their country, on their country's road or on their cities. So what is happening, especially in America, there are some states who have, you can say, banned Tesla. And Elon Musk is, you can say, working on uplifting that ban. So what happens that when you are going to introduce some tech in, you can say, in the world, you have to face these three issues, right? What are these three issues? These are the legal issues, these are the ethical issues, these are the regularity issues, right? You can also take an example of Google. Google have introduced its Google Map. I don't know the year of introduction of Google Maps, but what happens that obviously they have, you can say, they have some issue that people were saying that they are going to spy on world or whatever they were saying. Some people were saying that it would be good. Why? Because they will be there. It will be easy for them to navigate the world. It will be easy for them to just enter the coordinates and go wherever the destination they want to go. So what happens that when these things, when when a tech is going to introduce to yourself, obviously you face, when you are going to introduce some tech in the world, obviously that tech is going to face some problem, right? So I am so hopeful that I have explained well to you. Now I am open that you can ask questions.
Thank you, ma'am, for explaining. It was really helpful. Last question, ma'am, from my side is this one, that is there any word limit for article and the report writing?
Okay, is there any word limit for article and report writing? Okay, I will tell you in, you can say, next class, or I will
no problem guide you. And even about, yes, ma'am, continue.
I will guide you in, you can say, WhatsApp group.
All right, ma'am. And even yes, about ma'am, the presentation as well.
Yeah, also about the formats we're supposed to do these three activities in.
Okay, I will provide you the formats, okay? As well.
And even, ma'am, one more thing. Like at the end of every report or article, we mostly write bibliography or references. So is that mandatory as well? It would be helpful if you just write according to this thing as well.
Yes. Okay. Report have references and articles have a bibliography. So yes, you have to, you can say you have to give them. Why? Because you have to avoid plagiarism, right? Plagiarism is not allowed.
Yes, okay, ma'am.
If you are going to have, you can say, if your assignment is showing plagiarism, what will happen that your assignment will be nullified. Obviously, it will say that you are containing the, you can say, content that some articles, some other articles give, right? So how much you are allowed to, you can say, copy from internet or copy from another resource is 19%, right? It is the, you can say, standard, right? And if you are going to copy something, or if you are going to take help from something, which is having one source, so you can copy from one source, that is 10%, right? So what you have to do, let me tell you how you have to write an article if you are going to do. Okay, when we are going to write an article, that article have, you can say another format, and what the format does both have. Okay, follow just APA style, okay, in both of the things, right? Follow APA okay, style. Do you know about APA style?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what you have to do, you have to give a title to your report, right? For example, if your report is, you are writing an article on whatever the, you can say title is, you have to write that, right? Then next, you have to give some abstract. What is the abstract? Abstract is a brief summary of the study, whatever you have done. Right, you don't have to write it on the second point. For example, if you have written all of the report, then you have to write the abstract, but that abstract should be on, you can say, second point, right? Then we have introduction. You have to give a brief introduction of that, whatever the primary purpose of your report is. Then you have to give that, what are the skip that method and result part, right? In that part, you have to give whatever the point that was given to you. For example, the main pointers what were given to you. You have to write that. And then you have to specifically write, you can say, about whatever the data was provided to you, whatever the points you wanted to make. Then you have to make some discussion. In discussion, for example, I have told you that you have to elaborate negative and positive points, right? And then you have to give references, and then you have to give appendix, right? Okay, what is appendix? Appendix is, you can say, the references in, you can say, A to B, you can say, alphabetic order, right? So you have to write this report in this format. Okay, let me... Okay, there is also some help that you can get from here. They are saying you have to set page margins to 1 inch on all of the sides, right? Okay, yes, there we are. Then you have to double space all of the text, including heading. Then you have to indent the first line of the paragraph on 0.5 inches. You can see this, okay? And then you have used an accessible font. For example, what is the... you can say, what is the good font? Good font is Times New Roman, and it's 12 number font, right? Font style is your Times New Roman, and what is the font size? Font size is 12. Then you have to include a page number as well, right?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, just check this out, this page, just check this out. Okay, they are running a heading, right? Then they have the middle heading, then they have page number, then this also have the double space. Why are you giving double space? So that whoever your reader is, that reader can easily, you can say, study your paper, right? And this is the accessible font, they are using Times New Roman, right? Okay, now what is next? You have to make table of contents, right? Table of contents is very, you can say, important for that. And you also have to refer whatever the page is for that table of contents, right? Okay. Is there any
yes, ma'am.
Assignment you can ask? We have time. We have 5 minutes.
Ma'am, one thing, like you explained us, for articles, it's always bibliography, and for reports, it's always references, right? So right. One thing I just wanted to ask that what referencing style we are supposed to use? Mostly it's like Harvard one, but what will you suggest to use?
Harvard one is good.
All right. Thank you.
Okay. Does anyone else have any question about the assignments? I was willing, I was keen to, you can say, saying that you should start your assignments, right? Because I was told that 80% of your course is being explained to you. So I was saying that at least one assignment should I get from you people, right? So I will know that at which point you are you getting lectures or not, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And you know that this is the last month for your semester.
Yes, but ma'am, Rija asked over the group that, you know, what is the deadline. So I guess Ms. Nazmi, she said it's like 3 months for one assignment. Yes. Is it so?
For whole three assignments, you have 3 months, right? Not just one.
Okay, for whole three, that you mean by activity one, activity two, and activity three, right?
Yes.
All right. Then I'll start doing the first activity right away, so start that, you know, I can complete within a month.
Activity, so I will know in next class that where is your first activity now, right? Why I am saying this? I'm saying this so that I will know that whether you are doing something or not, right?
Yes, ma'am, you're right.
Right? For example, you know, this course of yours is not based on, you can say, this course of yours is not based on any of exams, right? It's based on just assignments, whatever you have done, right? So if you are going to participate in this assignment, what will happen that you will able to tell me that what are you going to understand about this assignment, and am I am I giving you the correct information about your course or not? Are you understanding me or not, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, in next class, you also have a quiz with me. That will be a short interactive quiz, right? Inshallah, in which I will ask about whatever I have taught you. So just revise the slides that I have given you. Okay, just forget about the activity one. What you have to do in next class, you have to be prepared about, you can say, your quiz, right? Quiz is not going to be tough. So your quiz is going to base on, you can say, the whatever the general knowledge is about that, general information about that subject which we are taking together.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Any other questions?
No questions, ma'am. Thank you very much.